Welcome everyone, family and friends of Christine and Norman, to this wonderful and joyous moment, a moment filled with hopes and dreams. I'm Christine and Norman's aunt, and I am honored and delighted and so pleased that they've asked me to join them in marriage today. You know, love is the miraculous gift of life. And a wedding is a celebration of that magic. Love is something over which we have no control. We can wish for it, long for it, ask for it, need it, but on our own we can't make that happen. So when love finds us, when the person we wouldn't want to live without crosses our path, it is truly a gift. And it is because that happened to Norman and Christine that we are here on this happy occasion. We've been invited here to celebrate the love that they have for each other and to recognize and bear witness to their decision to journey forward together in their lives. We are here to celebrate, to honor, to laugh, to dance, and be glad. Because the inevitable has happened. Love is alive and well, and this beautiful couple is here to prove it, and we are here to share it with them. So now, if you will bow your heads, we will have a prayer. Let us now join our hearts and minds together. Gracious Spirit, God of light, who gives us the longing for love and the capability of loving, we give you thanks for Christine and Norman, for their open hearts and willing spirits, and for the example of love that they embody here in our presence. Be with them on this joyous occasion of showing their love and making their vows, and be with us, their witnesses, that we all may be deepened by what is said and witnessed here. Bless them now that they may be filled with joy. May they keep the promises they make here with ease, and may love abide with them always. Norman and Christine, you may look at me now. So this is just for you. You are here because you've chosen to make a leap of faith. You have chosen to make visible your belief in life, strength, and hope for the future. Your own faith that love is real, constant, and abiding have led you here to make the ultimate commitment of marriage, being witnessed before family and friends and linking your lives in a tangible way. The spirit of this day will not always be with you. There will be moments when you have to reach deeper within yourselves to find a place of trust and patience. But nurturing yourselves, taking time for yourselves individually, and remaining faithful to your own spirit will give you greater resources of caring for one another. It's important to feed and strengthen your own light and to support your partner in doing the same. And that will also feed and strengthen the third being in your relationship, which is your marriage itself. As with all marriages, there will be problems, both great and small. You may hurt one another or be angry with each other, but this is just an invitation to refine your love and deepen it, to expand it with compassion, tender caring, and selfless nurturing. Any challenges you face will only make you more resilient and stronger as the two of you face them together. Most importantly, remember that love matters, and it is love, the love that you are celebrating and radiating here today, to which you must always return. Remembering it, holding it in your hearts and minds will give you through all the trials of life a marriage deep in joy and fulfillment. And you may all sit down. And now, as you have chosen to do a sand ceremony, I as a promise to join your lives together. You may take your individual vessels of sand that represent your lives from birth to this day. As you pour them into the central container representing your shared union, you are symbolically blending your individual lives into a marriage partnership, walking the road of life together from this day forward. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated, so too may you be united in love for the rest of your lives. And now we're ready to begin your vows. Norman and Christine have written their own, so we will begin with Christine. Christine, let me ask you a question first. Christine, do you take Norman to hold, honor, and cherish as your husband and life partner?
Yes, I do.
Then you may begin.
From class ring to wedding band, from first kiss to everlasting kiss, from first dance at prom to our first dance at wedding day, and having become a boy to a man, it has been a great adventure. When I met you, you were a boy who was sweet, caring, easygoing, and funny. Getting to know you, watching you change into a man you are today is a blessing. You are my superman. You always put my needs first, even when you have to sacrifice yours. You watch over me and make sure I'm safe and always smiling. I wouldn't be where I am today without you by my side. Give me strength and motivation to make up positive and strong, wake up positive and strong, to face life's challenges and to reach my goals. You are my supporter and provider, and when I'm feeling down or anxious, you are always there to get my mind off of the negative. With you by my side, I feel like I can conquer the world. You make me excited to look forward to be your wife. I vow to have and to hold you from this day forward, and to cherish you in sickness and in health for all eternity. You are my rock that grounds me, and you are my moon and my stars that keep me looking up. I love you always and forever.
Norman, are you ready? Norman, do you take Christine to hold, honor, and cherish as your wife and life partner?
I remember the first time that we met. We were in the courtyard at GHS, and in the middle of the spring, you were so excited about the world, and you were jumping up and down and spinning in a circle, talking about how beautiful the day was. And outside, all I could wait for was the fact that I just saw pure beauty. And I was lost in your sunshine and your blonde hair, which you don't have anymore. But I felt like nothing could stop in your sunny parade until you noticed me staring at you awkwardly and your beauty, and knowing I couldn't take my eyes off you, and I still can't. I didn't care if you knew that I was looking at you, but I do care that you know how much I love you. You left a burning image of your beauty in my mind, and I couldn't get that out. So, for now, I realize that we came together because of a mutual friend, Christine. Thank you, by the way. Sent you into my life.
Oh, no.
Sorry.
I loved you harder when you left to Kentucky to visit Aunt Michelle and Chad. I was heartbroken. I felt lost. I felt like I couldn't live without you at the time. But I know that we were meant to be. I felt it in my heart. I felt it in my soul. Even when I look every day at our cats and our dog, who's special, I know that we're meant to be, inside, out, and in my bones. My entire life, all I wanted was to find my better half, and I did. Don't know how I did, but I did. And as I'm reading this, I am definitely shitting my pants right now.
Sorry.
But the best part is, this is my favorite chapter of our life. We may have not started yet, but when we do, I know that I will always love you. And I do promise to be patient and try to understand you more, whether you're happy, mad, or sad. And to take time to be a better, stronger partner. And I promise to give you, and only you, all of me. I promise to commit to communicate with you more, because nothing's worse than closed off communication, as we learned through this process.
Planning a wedding.
And lastly, I promise to never go to bed mad at you, because that's the last thing I want to have as a memory, is you mad at me.
Let me see. I'll find my place here. May we have the ring, please?
The rings. Thanks,
Ben.
Old habits die hard, baby. I'm sorry.
Okay, so now I have the real ring. So, the circle of the wedding ring is symbolic of wholeness and completeness, and contains your love, hope, and trust. These rings are special because they say that you are loved and you have chosen to be bonded with one another, that you belong. May these rings from this day forward be your most treasured adornment, and may the love they symbolize be, to the end of your days, your most precious possession. Norman, we begin to you with you. Oh, that's you. You don't want to do that. There. Okay, Norman, as you put the ring on Christine's finger, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
To love you and cherish you.
Love you and cherish
you. Honor and respect you. To the end of my days. Christine? And repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my promise. To love you and cherish you. Honor and respect you. To the end of my days. And now, having shown us the example of your love and celebrated your union with the exchanging of rings, it is with great joy and happiness that I now pronounce you man and wife. Norman and Christine, you may kiss. Spirit, bless you, and may the wings of love uphold you throughout a prosperous and abundant life together. May your hearts be full. May your lips stay sweet. May your love grow stronger, and may you live long and happily in each other's arms. You are now one. Friends and family, I give you Mr. and Mrs. Norman and Christine Ramsey. Step into the reception area and wait for them and mingle around and get to know one another.